Good afternoon from across the pond, and happy Geography Awareness Week. Okay, so today I'm going to talk about human geography because that's what I do. As I said yesterday, there are a lot of elements to human geography. You can look at cultural geography, you can look at economic geography, you've got imperial geographies, political geography, there's migration studies, and apparently my lights are working again. Right on. And you may be sitting there thinking, wow, all these different types of geography are all over the place. How do you tie them together? But really, tying stuff like that together, history, economics, politics, culture, that sort of stuff, that's what geography does the best. And there's one particular instance that I think does this really well. Surely there are others, but the one I'm going to talk about is the French-Algerian hip-hop scene. Before we can even get into hip-hop, we gotta start talking about France's earlier relations with its colony Algeria. Algeria is in North Africa, as you may or may not know, and it's the 11th largest country in the world. The French occupation of Algeria began in the first quarter of the 19th century. And at that time you had probably, I don't know, tens of thousands of French moving into Algeria. While the French were occupying Algeria, this did a lot of bad things for the Algerian people. So basically, the French, they took all the best land, and the Algerians were having a real problem with the occupation at the time. Illiteracy rates were high. There was a lot of unemployment. Life for Algerians was reaching Star Wars Phantom Menace levels of suck. And to make things even worse, Algeria wasn't even considered a colony. Not in a legal sense, anyway. It was actually tied into the French state, so it was more or less just an extension of Paris. So, when European countries in the post-war era started liberating all their colonies, like England did for India, the Algerians are kicking back saying, what about us? So, basically, in 1954, after seeing all these other countries get their liberation and France was still holding on to Algeria, a bunch of Algerians in the National Liberation Front said, in the words of Lil Wayne, I'ma get mine. The Algerians began a bloody liberation process that resulted in the Algerian state we all know and love today. Now, in the time between the 1830s and the 1950s, a lot of cultural exchange had gone on between France and Algeria. Not only had tens of thousands of French people moved to Algeria and displaced Algerians from the land, but because of really, really crappy conditions, a bunch of Algerians moved to France. And the Algerians weren't the only ones making this exodus to France. Colonized people from places like Senegal and Côte d'Ivoire were also moving up north into the French suburbs with the Algerians. Fast forward to the late 1970s, early 1980s, when hip-hop was just finding its feet. Artists like Afrika Bambaataa and the Sugar Hill Gang were becoming really popular, not only in New York, but also across the Atlantic in places like Côte d'Ivoire and in France. And as post-colonial feelings of resentment still abounded in the suburbs of France, a bunch of French African youth found hip-hop to be a really good outlet for just getting out their giant squids of anger. The underground hip-hop scene allowed French Algerians to embrace their African roots and to do it in a subversive way that didn't piss off the authorities. Don't get me wrong, America has its racial hang-ups. But damned if the French suburbs don't burn once every 2 years because of post-colonial racial issues. So hip-hop for Algerians and Senegalese and I guess whatever you'd call people from Côte d'Ivoire. Côte d'Ivoireans? The underground hip-hop scene allowed these people to express their discontent with systemic French racism and general douchebaggery. Furthermore, it served as another node of discourse between hip-hop artists all over the globe. Especially concerning issues of racial discrimination and inequality, which was something that was also being addressed in North America at the time. But French Algerian hip-hop was also a form of religious expression. It served not only as a counterculture to the facade of secularism that some people accused the French of having, but it also served as a counterculture against the most draconian and severe forms of Islam. Now, the reason I relate this story to you is because I think geography really does a great job of tying it together. First off, you got spaces of power and spaces of colonialism in which the French just basically rolled into Algeria and took all their really good land, kicking a whole bunch of poor schmucks off of what was rightfully theirs. Not to mention the economic ramifications of the French just taking resources from one space that belonged to one people and hauling it back to their own country for themselves. Now, of course, this led to the subsequent migration of Algerians and other Africans into the suburbs of France. From there, these immigrants drew from the global hip-hop scene in order to reconnect with the land that they had formerly lived on, and the cultures therein. So, I think it's pretty dang evident how space and place play into French-Algerian hip-hop. And, of course, this is only a simplified version of the story. If you really wanted to, you could probably get way more intricate than I do here. And so, I encourage you, nay, I challenge you, to start thinking about how space affects these little things in life that you take for granted. Mom, when you sit down to knit and you start listening to your French hip-hop that you love so much, think about the spatial elements that went into just sort of creating the hip-hop music scene. And folks, that's all I got for today. I'm Jonathan Trinari, and I'm inviting you to space out with me over Geography Awareness Week. Okay, yeah. C'est les bras, sur fiston, c'est royal, c'est de la frappe, c'est les paradis.